Dr. Ramo, the Atkins diet, I remember when it came out, I got the burger with the cheese and the bacon and no bun, and it was this great thing, and there's a new revised version of it out.
Absolutely, and the Atkins diet actually got a lot of bad press, but in fact, if you look at your cholesterol levels, your triglyceride levels, your HDL, that diet actually was just as effective as the low-fat diet. Problem with it is you couldn't stay on it. Studies have shown that the best diet for losing weight over a short period of time is the low-carbohydrate diet, and that's Atkins. That means no more carbohydrate than 1.3 slices of bread a day. That's not very much, and that means it's very hard for you to stay on that diet. But over the one-year period, it was the best diet. No one stayed on it, so they've got a new one. The Atkins Foundation has funded a lot of research saying that this diet is better, easier to stay on. I've looked at it. It looks like it's still 20 grams of carbohydrate a day. That's very little bread. It also allows you later on to have a little bit more in the way of complex carbohydrates, and I think that makes a lot of sense. But I don't know that this diet is any easier to stay on. There's no data to show that long-term that it's any better. Mm-hmm. But if people are trying to lose weight, that low-carbohydrate diet, and as you know, I'm really against sugars.
Yes.
Any sugary drink or a lot of things white are going to put the pounds on and are going to change your cholesterol levels.
All right, so my bagel I had this morning, I'm off the Atkins diet. Dr. Ramo, thank you. You can catch this topic and other Healthbeat stories at KOAT.com.